What do you hear every day? Every day, 18 women in Australia will hear this. You have gynecological cancer. So when a patient meets me and we discuss a gynecological cancer diagnosis, I sometimes feel that we are at the beginning of a journey, and that journey is often full of hope and perspective. The situation is sometimes different though when there is maybe not so much hope of survival and when a life is truly cut short. So what drives me to research is that the care of women with gynecological cancer can be improved massively, and I can see that on the horizon where we need to go. At the moment, we treat a lot of women with one size fits all, and that is plainly wrong, because we could do better. In the future, I would like patients with all types of gynecological cancer to hear these words. We got this. We can treat this effectively at minimal side effects to patients.
When I first heard that I have ovarian cancer, it felt like the whole world went silent. I was diagnosed in 2017 at stage 3. I was 24 at the time. And for the past 5 years, I have been battling this disease. Before I was diagnosed, my life was so good. I was a flight attendant. I moved out of home. I purchased my first car. So I really had the world at my feet. I felt bulletproof. My treatment was very tough. I've had multiple chemotherapy drugs. It wasn't just tough physically, it was really tough mentally and emotionally. To find out that I am terminal and that the disease is incurable, I felt really scared. I felt frustrated and angry. I just wish no one had to hear the words, "You have a gynecological cancer." And if they did, I hope the first thought that comes to their mind is, "I can do this."
I'm a laboratory researcher. My day-to-day job is really focused on developing personalized treatment approaches for women. So what I really would like to do is be able to identify features of a woman's tumor or factors that might be circulating in her blood that will determine whether or not a woman will or will not respond to the treatment that is given. What's so exciting about the FEM Molecular Project, which is what I'm currently working on, is that we have a valuable resource of samples and information that have been collected from patients who participated in this clinical trial. Research is really hard to conduct because the main problem is that there's not enough funding. In Australia, the government does fund a lot of medical research, but there just simply isn't enough money to go around to fund all these brilliant ideas. That's why philanthropic organisations such as the Cherish Women's Cancer Foundation is so important. The research that I'm working on is likely to change the way that doctors treat gynecological cancer. The impact is anticipated to be global.
You can't change the everyday noise, and you can't change women hearing the words, "You have gynecological cancer," but you can change what happens next?